Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about Bluetooth mics and how to install them. So nowadays, a lot of head units not only give you much better sound quality compared to factory, but they also add a lot more functionality with USB, and the bigger thing nowadays is Bluetooth. Now we can do Bluetooth audio streaming through some sort of handheld device, and we can also do hands-free calling. Now in a lot of areas like ours, it's actually mandatory to use some sort of device like this. Yes, I disagree that it's actually the conversation that takes away from the dexterity of driving, but the law is the law. So today we're going to go over different placements of the Bluetooth mic, and different possibilities where we can install them. This is a typical installation you'd see for a Bluetooth mic run. Clipped on the headliner, all the wiring tucked up nicely. In this position, what you get is it's far from the windows, you're not going to get any wind noise, the repeaters here are exposed, and the driver can just talk normally, and you're going to get probably some of the best reception possible for placement. Aesthetically, this is probably the most pleasing way to put in a Bluetooth mic in a vehicle. I just flush mounted it in my truck, but now what you have to realize is because of those repeaters, because I cover them off on the sides, you are going to sacrifice a decent amount of performance depending on the vehicle. For me, I didn't really care what other people thought of how clear I sound on the other side. I'd rather look better in my truck, but most of the installs, we don't do it like this because most people want to hear a lot of clarity on the other side. I went for aesthetics. It is possible to do, but you have to remember you are sacrificing performance. So in some installs, your only choice might be to only put it on top of the steering column right over here. It is a good place as far as reception goes because it's right in front of your mouth, but I don't think it looks that great. So if you can, in some vehicles like this one, take the gauge cluster out and we can place it behind. I'm going to show you what it looks like on the bench. Okay, so I have the gauge bezel on the vehicle, on the bench here, that way you can see better what's going on. Same idea as doing the headliner. So depending on which direction the wire is going to go, you're going to loop the opposite way. So we're just going to pretend we're going to go this way, and you're going to put the clip behind here. And then you test fit to make sure that the gauge cluster, this thing can go back in, and it's going to fit nicely. But now, when you look at it, you don't see any visible wires. It's just a clean mic install. So it can go in the corner, it can go in the middle. It really just depends on what's going on underneath here and in the vehicle, and then you just adjust accordingly. So we're going to go into detail over the most common install that you're going to see most vehicles get is putting it up in the headliner up here. So this is a 2002 RSX, very common style of vehicle where we have an easy to remove A-pillar and a headliner that's not really glued at the edge of the windshield. So we're going to just remove the molding, pull it down, remove your A-pillar, cover. Now, with the wire, it is shielded with this rubber insulation, but it isn't the most durable thing, so be careful with it. So you'd like to take your clip, and you just clip it up here. Now, to take extra care, take the wire and loop it inside the opposite way. That way, if it wants to come loose, the clip will hold it in. Because if you don't do that, what happens over time is the wire always drips down from the windshield. So take care of the headliner, be gentle with it. And then you're going to work the wire behind it. Now the biggest thing to always consider also here is, get to this point, make sure you get the wire deep in here because you want to hide everything. Most people won't see it, but take the extra care. So now, we're lucky here, we have factory wiring. Now you can either zip tie or zap strap this all the way down, or since you have wiring here, you just begin to loop it around. So, just loop all the way down. And then keep on going, then head down to the dash. If you didn't have this wiring, you could use some good duct tape or something, and then fasten it here, and then go ahead and put your A-pillar back on. Okay, so you have your wire here, it's very unsightly, and you need to run it under the dash. Now, what I usually use in the shop is something like this, where
I can easily run it through down any opening with a wire attach. You can also use really long zap straps or a coat hanger, whatever you want. I just find this one easier because we do it all day long, so we use the tool for it. So we're going to release the underdash. Take our tool, grab onto it, feed it down. Now some cars you have enough room where you could just run it down this way, but I'm just showing you this because in case you have a vehicle where you don't have this kind of room. So come to the other side, and you pull your wire through. Okay, now you're under the dash. Now to run the wire, what you want to do is, you want to run up and over any other wires, kind of like this. I would come up above this one, but it's a little bit hard for me to get the handle holding the camera. But see how the wire is resting up on here now? So if your cable tie were to fail, at least you can still rely on the wiring up here to hold it. Other things you have to consider are, there are moving parts under the dash. Brake. In this situation, clutch, and also the steering shaft does not have a metal shield on it. So these are all things to consider, that this wire, any wiring you run under the dash, can get hung up on, caught on, torn, whatever. So you're gonna cable tie this all up nicely and keep in mind staying away from all the moving parts. Okay, at this point you've done your wiring for your head unit. You've run the wire up similar to the way we ran it through the dash and everything. Keep in mind, when you're inside a dash, there's lots of metal pieces here, and they don't finish them away because they don't expect you to put your hands in there and everything, but they do have sharp edges. Keep the wiring away because it is going to chafe, and then you're going to run into issues with that. So before you plug this into the appropriate spot on your head unit, you want to just tie it up nicely and short it, because typically it's pretty long because they just make it a long length because they don't know what kind of vehicle it's going to go in, and you're going to have a lot of excess wire. So you know, tie it up nicely so when you get in the dash, it's going to be all nice and neat. It's not going to get tangled around in there. And then just go ahead and plug in the back of your head unit. So yeah, guys, hopefully that helped give you some insight to what Bluetooth mics are and how to properly install them.